We'll wait a few minutes to get everyone joined in here. Hope that your internet is working. I know we've been experiencing some technical difficulties recently. I'm sure you all are as well, since everyone's doing their schoolwork and their regular work from home. And I mean, Netflix and chill when you have time too. So hopefully you can see us, not blurry, and it's working on your end as well. We can't see you guys, unfortunately. Usually on our Skype, we're able to see everyone that we're working with, but through here, to reach a larger audience, you know, we're doing a Instagram. So we're going to turn the comments off in a little bit once we start dancing so that you guys can see and not be distracted, but we will turn them back on every few minutes or, you know, throughout, just to make sure it's working.
And for the next like 30 seconds or so, let us know if you can hear us, let us know if you can see us, let us know if there are any problems, so that before we turn off commenting, we know if we're having any issues before we get started. And then we'll try and turn commenting back on at a couple points during the class, just in case there are any issues. But, you know, once we tell you we're turning commenting off, not really any point to comment.
They're actually physically not able to.
Yeah, exactly.
But if you do have questions about the class, about technique, about things, please DM us or email us through our website, and we will do our best to get back to you. Again, as we've mentioned before, it's just the two of us, two and a half, so she's slowing me down big time in here. 25 weeks pregnant, official today, so So good thing, we're growing our team a little bit bigger to help us out.
Exactly. She'll be doing all the emails in 18 years or so.
But thank you all for joining in again. We had such a great response from the first one, so we wanted to do some more. We're going to keep trying to do these as much as we can. Maybe do a point class, maybe do cross training. We'll see. You know, we're getting pretty busy with things as well, and I know everyone's trying to keep up with their daily schedule. So another thing too is let us know what time is better. We're trying not to, I know everyone's all over the world, so it's very difficult to accommodate everyone. But
if we get, you know, if we get 50 messages and 49 of them say Thursday at 4, we'll do our best to accommodate
maybe
that.
You know what? I'll do some stories and we can do some things on there for that. But we know there's, you know, dinner time, homework time, all of that. So, and we're trying to accommodate with our virtual schedule with our private and group classes. So we will keep you updated on those. We have some new pricing options available. Again, working with our internet to make sure that we can accommodate it all. But we promise to get that out to you as soon as possible on our website, through here, everything. But we are trying to do some smaller group classes that are more affordable for everybody. And then, of course, our private lessons, one-on-one, where we can see you and we can really work with you like you're in the studio to keep progressing to, you know, be able to start back where you left off. So let's begin. I think we're, you know, got a good enough people here to start. So again,
turning off comments.
Glad you can hear us. For those of you, again, we didn't even introduce ourselves this time. Lauren Faisley Vayette.
Francis Vayette.
Vayette Virtual Ballet School, former principal dancers, Pennsylvania Ballet.
Been the Merc.
Miami City Ballet. Leave pregnant. So, Mr.
Let's
Fran,
start the way we always
yes,
do
always
dancers.
Starts with a
we'll
plank.
Do our plank. And I hit play for me there. There we go.
Turn that up, I think, a little bit, would you please? Tummy towards your spine, slight tuck to your pelvis, neutral head and neck. Right leg goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Up to the side. Back to the center, still lifting the right. Switch left.
keep breathing. Keep your hips down in a nice straight line.
Out to the side.
Careful of how your wrists are placed. You don't want to put any extra strain on them.
I'm out of shape, dancers.
Still got 15 more seconds for 2 minutes.
Right side. If you have trouble balancing, separate your feet.
You can also do this on your knee, one knee on the ground, to help stabilize as well.
Like that. If you're ready for it, lift that top leg. Switch. Center and hold.
Okay.
With that.
2 minutes
gracious.
And 45 seconds there for your plank. Good job, everyone.
Shut up, Instagram. I'm not out of breath here.
This will help us get in shape, too. So
yeah.
We like to do the planks in the beginning to just warm up the entire body.
Yeah, get a little bead of sweat going. Next thing we're going to go ahead and warm up is our calves. So we'll
Francis will
bar.
Show the combinations, and then I'll demonstrate with you with the music. So in case you don't get it the first time, don't worry.
So we'll face the bar, and we'll just do releves in first. 2 counts up, 2 counts down, 2 counts up, 2 counts down. That's all. Miss Lauren's shoulders are down, her lats are pulling, she's wrapping her outer hip muscles around the back and spiraling her inner thighs forward.
And as I come back down, I put my heels all the way on the floor, but I don't shift my weight back to them, so that I'm ready to go right back up onto those toes when I'm ready. That's also really important once we get into pointe shoes later, ladies, that we want to be right over that box and right back down so that we can move quickly as well.
Okay. Let's do some pliés, dancers. We'll go demi 1, 2, demi 3, 4. We're on plié 5 and 6 and 7. Tendu immediately to second 8. Demi 2, 3, 4. Grand plié 6 and 7. Tendu to 4th. Demi 2, 3, 4. Grand plié 6 and 7. Tendu to 5th. Demi-demi, grand, and fifth. We'll port de bras forward, we'll port de bras back, we'll port de bras side, we'll port de bras side. We'll susu, we'll take a nice long susu balance. We will susu to the other side right away. Yes? 2 demis in a grand in first, 2 demis in a grand in second, 2 demis in a grand in fourth, 2 demis in a grand in fifth. Port de bras forward, back, side, side. Susu and balance, susu to other side. Out over your pinky toes.
Put your heels down to come back up. Again, no weight in the heels. They are on the floor, not lifted. We don't have the weight sunk back.
As Lauren goes ahead and puts her weight right in the center of both feet. She's not sitting back, she's not sitting forward. She drops her tailbone in the middle of the plié. And when she straightens, and a nice, beautiful, smooth port-de-bras forward and back with an actively held fifth position. You'll notice Miss Lauren's fifth position hasn't moved. She's still holding her muscles. She's still turning out. She's still straightening her knees. Nice long balance in susu. Her shoulders are down, giving her a nice long neck. Her ribs are closed. Her back muscles are held. You're rotating your thigh bones, squeezing your popo, and dropping your tailbone straight down. End of the phrase coming, so we sutenu. Tendu back to first. And. Forward in her nice high demi point.
And throughout the whole exercise, really trying to keep those ribs corseted. I obviously have a 25-week belly here, but I'm still trying to engage those ribs to keep everything nice and together.
Let's see here. That one will do. Okay, so we'll face the bar in first position, dancers, and we'll go one lower, one and first, one plié, and one and first, and one tendlié, one tendlié, stretch over and two. Oh, one, two, that one goes straight. Oh, one big plié, three and four, one and two, one and two, one, six, seven, and eight. Okay, that's all. Here we go. Plié. Strong back muscles, dropping your tailbone and a big stretch to the side. And we close. And press into the floor. Lower straight and rotate it.
And then come right back up onto that supporting side. Every time.
stretch. Good, release. Yeah.
Yeah, anytime we do a plie like that, we want to send the weight directly down, tailbone flat, so you evenly have the weight, and then we push right back up onto that supporting side. Almost like the same kind of plie you would do if you were about to do a jump. We don't want to just kind of rock our way through, because then we're not building any strength or power in our legs.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's see here. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll do it a little bit faster. So, here's what we'll do, dancers. We'll take a fifth position and we'll go chandu out and two and three and four, in and two and three and four, out and two and three and four, in and two and three and four, out and two and three and four, in and six and seven, eight, one and two and three and four, in and six and seven, eight, one and two, one and two, one and two, one and two, two, one and two, one and two, two, one, 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 and, supinu. Four counts out, four counts in on quad. Two counts out, two counts in on quad. Ones, ands. Yeah?
Sorry, our floor is a little sticky here in our leather shoes, but it's good for the resistance we're wanting to build.
Okay, here we go, dancers. Four, then two, then one, then and. Out, two, three, arrive, four. In, two, three, arrive, four. Out, two, three, arrive, four. In, six, seven, and eight. Her knees are stretched. Square shoulders, her elbows lifted. She's really rotating her standing leg. Sorry, this is mean. This is a hard combination. Seven. Two counts. Two. In and two. One and two. One and two.
You're doing the support on this side, so you don't bend the knee to come in, but you're lifting to make room for the fifth position.
One count. One. One. Nice and sharp out there, dancers. And big plie, susu, soutenu, other side. Miss Lauren's shoulders are down. This is going this way. Her elbow's coming that way, and then her palm and her wrist are going that way. And she stretches through the backs of her knees.
Toes initiate to the back, and then the heel brings you in into the side. We go directly side or in front using our turnout, not shifting our hips. And you keep this up as you go faster. Really feeling all the weight on that supporting hip.
You will also notice that Miss Lauren has five individually placed fingers. She doesn't squeeze any of them together. There's not a lot of tension in her hands. The tension doesn't go here or here, a little bit here, but a lot in your back muscles. That's where the tension goes.
And the purpose of that combination is, you know, we're spending the time working nice and slow, feeling all the correct positions and muscles, so that then when we start to move faster, we do that as well. So we're training our bodies to just naturally remember where we want to be for those positions so we can move faster.
Mm-hmm. I say for like 2 seconds, we'll turn our comments back on and check in with you guys and see how we're doing. Can you see? Can you hear? Have the combinations been clear? Do I need to, like, you know, show it a little bit better?
Well,
good luck, dancers. I'm an old retired guy.
Let's start going.
Okay. All right. So, next combo. This will be a long one, so let's make sure. I'll show it with the music so that we make sure it works.
Yeah, we're trying to do a little bit more
aerobic, maybe?
Longer combinations and going right away to the left so that we can keep up that stamina that we need.
Okay, here we go. I may not show this entire thing. We go 1, 2, 3, 4. Enveloppe, enveloppe. Conlié to the back. Enveloppe back. Enveloppe side. Conlié, 2, 3, 4. Enveloppe, enveloppe. 1, 2, 3, 4. Enveloppe, enveloppe. Conlié, 2, 3, 4. Pas de cheval, pas de cheval. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pas de cheval, pas de cheval. Honey, would you stop the music for me? We do that on the left. Then we do our tonlier 2 and 3 and 4. We do 2 dégagés. 2 dégagés. Tonlier 2 and 3 and 4. 2 dégagés. 2 dégagés. Left. Last time we go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. We go double PK. Double PK. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Double PK. Double PK. Okay? So the tonlier always stays the same. Tonlier 2 and 3 and 4. We do enveloppe, enveloppe, front and back, right and left. We do pas de cheval, front and back, right and left. 2 dégagés, front and back, right and left. Double piqués, front and back, right and left. Yeah? This is a long one.
Keep breathing, keep dancing. When it starts getting tired in your legs, really using that upper body, continuing to dance.
Yeah. And the one correction that I always give my kids for this before we get going, right? I always want my students to do a U-shaped or a box-shaped tonlier. So we go down on one side, then move along the bottom, and then on the other, we go up. So we don't go into the middle and then shoot up on a diagonal, so we don't do a V. We go plié here, down, reach along the bottom, and then come up on the other side. This is a very slight adjustment so that you can maintain control all the way through.
But also, we know you're dealing with restrictions in space. So if you have to go straight down, still feeling that turnout, it is completely correct as well.
And if you can't do it now, keep it for later. Here we go. Beautiful scooping action of the toes. Lift in place, lift in place.
You're really just presenting that heel.
Lift in place.
Heel.
2 dégagés. Deep, long breaths in your nose, dancers, and out your mouth. Last time with our double PKs. Deep breath. So yeah, then like a little note on our little tonlier note, right? Our U-shaped tonlier. First of all,
sorry, we had no room for that.
first of all, any sort of correction that we give is always something that, like, it's generally the way we like to do it. It's never the way it is, right? There are sort of a lot of people out there in the ballet world that will say this is right and that's wrong. It's something we try very hard to avoid. Since we've run into that through all these different techniques, you know, there are a lot of techniques out there. There's, you know, Vaganova and Balanchine and Cicchetti and the French school and the English school. Like, there's a lot of different ways to do things. So this note about a U-shaped tonnier is just one that I like to do, one, to make sure that when we plie, this knee goes in the right direction, right? Because as soon as we start to fall, it's really easy to roll on that standing foot and do that to your back knee, right? So this kind of makes us stay put. And then if we do that, we can slow-mo control every little bit of that process as opposed to falling and falling and hoping we're going to be okay. So, let's do a quick dégagé to the side with a port-au-bras. This is a new one that some of my students will recognize. We'll just go into, out, to, into, out, to, up, to, out, to, plié, into new. In, out, in, out, plié, sous, sous. And we'll do that four times, right, left, right, left. Let me make sure I have
really
the right.
Really important left. In the first position for the dégagé, that we don't let the weight take us that way. We really want to stay nice and pulled up on that supporting side so that this leg is never moving. This is your solid tree trunk, scissor legs, and then we're creating the beautiful branches up on top.
Yep. Ready, dancers? Here we go. Good. Excellent. Let's do a rond de jambe, I think. Yeah? Let's do 7, 8, rond de jambe, 2, 3, brush, rond de jambe, 2, 3, brush, rond de jambe, brush to the front, a little higher, rond de jambe, brush arabesque, brush front plié, passe, second, rond de jambe, 2, 3, brush arabesque at 45. Rond de jambe, 2, 3, brush 45. One rond de jambe, brush a little higher. One rond de jambe, brush a little higher. Brush plié, retiré, développé, close. Let's circle and reverse and passe balance right after that, okay? Here we go, dancers. Trying to rub the backs of your knees together as you do your rond de jambe, dancers.
Supporting side lifting.
So as Miss Lauren goes, you'll notice every time she passes through first position, it's her real first, not a modified one for a rond de jambe. She's rubbing her knees together.
Using again how you shape the foot. Heel forward, toes back when you're going to the front, and you reverse the hip back. Lift to that passe.
nice smooth circular movement, not four stretches.
Yeah, I always like to think like my hand's a paintbrush and I'm painting the room. While keeping those knees and the weight stable. Plie, susu up before you go to that passe, so you can get that nice square hip. And then we want to draw that leg up into that passe for the balance. I can't guarantee you I'm going to be able to balance right now, but...
Little help from baby.
You do your balance. Really important for the balance, again, that those elbows stay lifted. And that's for your pirouettes as well. Once you drop the elbows, all of this kind of sinks in and we're not using our back. So however you hold your arms, they can be first position, they can be crossed a little bit, you know, especially for partnering, but we never want to drop the elbows down.
And plus, there's also, you know, certain schools teach a first position that's opposite your heart. Certain teach opposite your belly button. Doesn't matter to us whatsoever. Matters if it's held and strong.
Yeah.
I'll try and put enough music to actually balance this time. That's my mistake, dancers. That's a pet peeve of mine. Like, we should dance to the music. So when the music ends, we should end. But I forgot and I didn't put enough bars there.
And
so
you can balance longer than me. I was joking with students earlier through Skype that we could see. I was like, Make me think that you froze, that your Wi-Fi froze. That's how good your balance is.
Also, just my Wi-Fi. I might have a frozen Wi-Fi. Here we go, dancers.
No problem. Keeping that turnout all the way through. So here, the toes go back, the heel comes around. Pelvis in the double case. Keeping that elbow lifted in second position the whole time.
You will also notice that Miss Lauren's standing leg never changes directions. It doesn't rotate in response to her rendezvous. Meaning, she's holding her leg turned out the whole time.
And it burns! Big plie, air best, whatever the height is, bringing it in. Inner thigh. It doesn't have to be high, but we want the inner thighs engaged. Making sure you go all the way back. I can't do that anymore.
Big plie, beautiful susu.
Yeah, making sure you feel that balance before you even draw it up to passe. I'm already on my leg, ready to let go.
Good. Seven. Good.
Not bad for a 15-pound belly.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. So, one other quick thing before we move on. One thing to always notice, or an easy way to notice whether or not you are holding your turnout in your rendezvous, is what happens to your supporting knee, right? If I do this incorrectly, you will notice my standing knee changing directions as I'm going around. If I do this correctly, I don't know if I can anymore. You'll notice that it doesn't, right? That I keep my knee via your inner thigh muscles rotating actively. Then it doesn't react to whatever's happening with this leg. Okay, let's do. Put some music on. Make sure I have the music that I want. Make sure that the combo actually fits the music. Let's go. Fondue, out, plie, releve, fondue, out, plie, releve, fondue, out, plie, releve, balance,
six, seven, eight, and two, plie, releve, fondue, two, plie, releve, fondue, two, plie, releve, balance, soutenu to the other side right away.
We will slow this down a little bit, dancers. I just did that to sort of make it quicker to show and not waste time, okay? But also, no worries on the balance there. Just do your best, okay? This is a test as much as anything else. It's not really meant to be perfect or anything like that. It's a check of your balance.
Yeah? But one thing to help with it, at least to think about it while you're doing, is so you're doing that plie, that fondue. You want to already be where you are for that fondue so that you don't shift the weight and then you have to get back over for that releve. From the plie, right there, plie, releve. Keeping those thighs engaged, almost like you're in a susu the whole time. It's just out here. And everything coming again from that supporting side. It's so helpful.
Yeah. Here we go, dancers.
Coming right back down to it as well. So here, lifting up to come down.
Fancy.
Knee goes up and out, rotating that leg. Oops.
You will also notice, dancers, the nice big diamond shape that she makes between her knees when she does a plie. Left side. Use your turnout. Plie, stretch your knees.
Resist that coming down in the plie. Don't just slam it back down. Through the foot.
And the more you stretch your back knee, the easier it will be to balance.
Oh, this one's good with the belly.
Plie, stretch, stretch, stretch. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Good, okay. So, let's try something that's kind of interesting. I discovered it a while ago, just sort of by accident, right? And then I've asked one of our, we have one of our online students whose mother is a physical therapist and really good one, just like, really brilliant, and I was giving this correction one day to the student and saying that, like, I don't understand why it works, and she explained it, and it's really complicated, and I still don't really understand it. The short version is, especially in arabesque for some reason, the more you straighten your back arabesque knee, the easier time you will have of holding your balance and feeling your balance, okay? So, what though I can't see you, take a second right now, and practice that. Do your little 45 degree releve and arabesque. Try and balance with the released back knee and then straighten the crud out of it and see what happens now.
And really it's a lengthen of the straightening of the knee.
Yeah.
So not just locking that knee, but thinking of the length throughout the foot out to the other side of the wall.
Yeah. Okay. Let's do, do you want to do an attitude swing?
Sure.
Yeah, let's do that.
I can't do it.
We'll go like this. You know what? I'll do this one. It'll just be 13 attitude swings front and back and then suit new to the other side right away. Okay? Here we go.
There's some medical things I'm not allowed to do.
We go one. Two, one, ooh, that is a big high attitude to the back.
Keep that knee lifting, not rotating the whole time. Supporting leg should stay straight. Really turning out in the back attitude. He's retired, it's okay.
If I could still do an attitude, I might not have retired. All right, next thing, let's do a slow four count développé en croix, right and left. Yeah? Développé, two, three, close four. Développé, six, seven, eight. Développé, two, three, four. Développé, six, seven, soutenu, eight.
One
en croix. One en croix. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
One.
One, one, one.
I can still get this leg up, but I cannot get the other. My pelvis is very warped right now. Even when you can't get your leg as high as you want, still feeling the energy and reaching, making a beautiful position.
Also, dancers, doing a high développé and doing a good développé are often, most times, two different things.
Yeah, I can still go 90 degrees here and keep the rotation, and that's much more important than raising my hips or losing my turnout to get the leg up.
We've all seen that really high développé, right? We want turnout and placement above all else.
And the more you do that correctly, then you can work on getting the height in that position. We personally would rather see a 90 degree turned out position than one of these.
Well, I'll tell you what, there are a lot of reasons for that. The primary one, to me, is once you establish the proper technique and placement, that is the hard part. In no uncertain terms, that's the hard part. Anybody can whack a limb, anybody can, you know, do it incorrectly and make it look, I could still do a développé above 90 if I wanted to let everything go. But once you've established the proper technique, it's really hard to defeat that. That technique holds up, it's strong, it has stamina, it doesn't give out at weird times. It's not like, oh, I'm on the stage now, the lights are in my eyes and I can't do a développé front. That technique holds up. And then all you have to do for the next few years, if you want it to get higher, is make tiny little incremental progress.
And I think that this is a really good time to do that. Since
Absolutely.
You are kind of alone in your house and no one is judging you about how high it is, use this time to be beneficial, to actually, you know, work on those bad habits that have crept in, to really establish the correct technique so that then when you are able to get back into the studio with your colleagues and your teachers, that you've, you know, really used this time to gain the strength and get better.
Yeah, and you know, like... yeah, do a frappe. You want to do a frappe? Should we do a frappe?
I think we should do a grand battement in the center and go.
Grand battement and then go to the center?
In center.
Oh, do a grand battement in center?
Yeah.
Oh.
If we have the space.
Okay. All right.
We're
yeah.
Running out of time.
We can do that. All right. Hang on. Let me get rid of the bar, dancers.
Sorry, just so that we can try to keep moving, we're gonna do a grand battement in center. I think it might actually be easier with the space a little bit, just so that we don't have to keep moving with the bar as well. And now you can kind of... open up maybe in the living room, move some chairs. I had to move my cat earlier today. She's trying to get involved. It's dangerous. That is one thing. Please, everyone, please be very careful with your space and your floors. It's not worth getting injured at this time.
Okay. Well, let's make it a little bit interesting. See if we can do that. Let's go croisé, dégagé, grand battement, tendu, change. Tendu, two dégagés, grand battement effacé, tendu écarté, and change. And we go croisé, two dégagés en face, one grand battement effacé. I'm not doing that. Close, tendu, dégagés, grand battement, and tendu, change. Yeah?
And And yeah, you move forward and back accordingly to not hit other people and things.
Proximity warning, dancers. Check your surroundings. Make sure the pets are out of the way.
And we're using the positions, the pose and all of that, you know, so that we can use more of that space. We're really making sure that, you know, we're still, even without the mirror, using that ekamal, keeping those legs crossed to the front, right? Not a ground bat ma out here. You're less likely to hit, you know, a chair the more consolidated we are.
Here we go. Front is front. No matter what direction you face, it goes right in front of your belly button.
Baby's taking over. So I didn't do the greatest job of demonstrating that, but ideally what we would want to do is tendu front. Now, instead of doing kind of like what I did, where I went 1, 2, we would really want us to go all at once. So both inner thighs come forward, and then same for that grand mama. The only way to achieve that, again, is to not have those weights stuck back in the heels. To the back, really, really hard, right? So from here, again, both thighs coming forward, and then again for that grand mama, pulling up on that supporting set.
And something she did really well, right? That's really important to us, and we don't have time in this situation to sort of get into it. But at the bar, you'll notice that our bar has relatively little écarté, effacé, quasi changes in it. And that's for a reason. It's not that there's anything wrong with that. That is wonderful. But we like to spend a lot of our bar practicing the cross, right? Front is front, side is side, back is back. So that when we get to the center, those positions are intact. No matter which direction Miss Lauren faced, her tendu or her dégagé or her grand battement was right in front of her belly button. And since, like, you know, grand battement is an extension of a dégagé.
My belly button's sticking out even more. It's easier to feel it.
Grand battement is an extension of dégagé, and dégagé is an extension of tendu. You could almost think of tendu as an extension of fifth position, right? It's kind of like there's not a new step. We're doing the same step in three directions, and it all stays the same. And like we tell our kids too, if your grand battement goes high enough, and you don't use any épaulement, it should hit you in the nose. Not the shoulder, not the cheek, right in the nose. That bottom arm keeps going straight, right up the center line. Yeah? Let's do our pirouette combination. I think we should do the same one we did on Sunday, just to give us another chance. One, it stays put. Two, we repeat exercises. We do tendus every day. So let's try this again and see how it goes for you in your situation, right? So tendu front, plié, relevé, passé, change. Tendu second, plié, single pirouette, change. Tendu arabesque, fourth, single pirouette, two, fourth, tendu, fourth, double pirouette.
Just so you know, Mr. Francis whipped out his old Swan Lake boots for today's class so that you could see his feet better on this floor. So,
they're
yeah.
Just knuckling.
We're going real official here, but it is quite sticky on the Marley with our leather shoes. So.
Tendu front and plié, relevé, passé, and fifth. Tendu second, plié, single pirouette to fifth. Tendu arabesque to fourth, single pirouette to fourth. Tendu to fourth, single or double to fifth.
Again, be careful on whatever floor you are on and shoes. I'm doing singles. It's all beneficial. Mm-hmm.
Good. Okay.
Even when you're kind of struggling with pirouettes, what I was trying to focus on for that is really keeping that back lifted. Like, me not feeling like I can use my legs really well. I was trying to focus more on my spot and then using that arm to come around so that regardless if you're here, whichever it is, that we don't do one of these, we can either plie around this way or we can bring it in. But whatever it is, this side can't be released. It has to be engaged to help us around.
Yeah, there's another, for us, for me, I'll say for me, I won't even say for Miss Lauren, I'll say for me. I always want my students to generate the force for a pirouette from their legs, right? And it's funny, it's something we know from the time we learn to walk, that our legs move our body around. You know what I mean? We walk around all day on our legs. We don't walk from here to the kitchen to get dinner on our hands. Our legs find our balance really easy and they create a lot of force really easy. And then for some reason we get to pirouettes and we all start winding up from the other side, like literally the opposite side of our body from what we normally use to move our body around. And if you see like certain, like on Instagram, certain of the really great turners, like do their arms move? Yes, but from where? It moves from your back or it moves your back. Goes like this. One of my favorite, actually, I think was tuned in a little bit ago. You still hear Poppy?
Big Poppy Molina.
Dude, Big Poppy's turns are just freaking awesome. And sometimes it looks
that's
like
Ariane Molina, the principal dancer at Pennsylvania Ballet.
He barely even moves his arms, but his legs and his back and his stomach are just like freaking diesel. You know what I mean? So this is like, it's actually from watching him turn that I developed a whole different series of exercises to learn to turn from the right place. I'll have to talk to you about it sometime, Poppy, and see if I'm right about it or not. See if my thinking is what you do. That one?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's try. We'll do four changement, tendu fourth, en dedans fifth. Four changement, and four tendu fourth, en dedans fifth. Okay?
Let's just do right left.
Nice and easy. Yeah.
So I suggest that for this combination, try to start back in whatever space you are in. Maybe you need to turn your direction. But the four changements, stay in place. Again, like we talked about on Sunday, not jumping super high. This is more about how you land, getting those heels down to the floor, the articulation, and then tendu fourth. Again, not winding up, not shifting, really keeping that quasi using that arm. For a single, double, triple, whichever, I'll be doing singles. Just here right and left, and then we'll stop. We can repeat if we have time.
Here we go, dancers.
This
is gonna be
fast.
Oh, hang on. Hold on, that's a little fast, quite frankly.
I knew you're fast, I can't do it.
Here we go. Good.
Let's do one more time.
Yeah.
Move it on back.
Good. Okay. Well,
I think that's good for
the
dancing.
I think that's probably good.
Today, we will, try to do,
turning the comments on so that if you have a question really quick in the last, 2 minutes.
Well, it does shut us off. It does shut us off at exactly 1 hour. We are going to see if we can try to save it this time. I know last time it only stayed around for 24 hours, but we recorded it on our computer as well, so we'll try to get that out to you guys. We are making adjustments to our website, www.fayettevirtualballetschool.com. That will be coming soon. Again, as we said, we're trying to do some new pricing options so you can have more interactive classes because these are really great. It's been nice to, be able to teach you guys, but we can't see you. And that's what's so important, especially in this field, is that interaction and finding what corrections you need for what you are working on.
Yeah, we will be doing another class. We'll probably be doing another one of these Instagram classes at some point. We don't know when yet, so stay tuned.
Yeah, we'll keep you updated on social media. You guys know where we are there, so.
One of the things we're trying to do at VVBS to meet the need that's happening with what's going on in the world in coronavirus, you know, COVID-19, is to offer like different pricing options so that you can sort of maybe get together with some friends and buy a class from us and stuff like that so that everybody can pay less. It's
working with the internet too. We're still figuring all that out. So
right.
We appreciate you guys being patient with us with all of that. You've been wonderful. And again, it's just us and we're trying to respond to everyone. So we will do our best with that. We were on Conversations on Dance yesterday. We were scheduled to record that like months ago. And wow, how relevant is it now? So that is out, so check that out on Conversations on Dance. You can learn a lot more about us and what we've been doing for the past almost 2 years now. This is what we've been doing, so really great for you guys to be able to hear all that, and yeah.
Yeah, someone just wrote, like, you know, about our group classes, you're not supposed to get together with other people.
Oh yeah, no, you would
no,
do it
we
at
are,
your own
home. We are able to host a group class on Skype with people in multiple locations. We're working that out with sort of a test group right now where we're figuring out sort of the number of people we can actually have do it and still interact.
Yeah, because that's what's
right?
most important to us. We can give these stock classes to anyone, but we really want to be able to work, be able to see you guys and give you the corrections.
Yeah.
So, everyone we've been doing with, they are in their own home. So safety first, for sure.
Price range would be somewhere around $20 to $25, something like that. Probably
per
$25,
person.
But
yeah.
Like we'll see. It depends a little bit also on how many we're able to do. Like on the iPad here, on our home computer setup and stuff,
really
we can get a few more. So we wouldn't want it to be just a whole big bunch of you in a bubble where we couldn't actually see you, then we might as well do this.
Yeah, that's not worth it. We're really more about the quality than the quantity. And that's why we've been giving the classes that we have been, instead of just kind of giving combinations. We still want to try to give some feedback because I know it's very daunting to know that you have to kind of go back and, it's not the same just taking a regular class, especially when you're a student, you know, as a professional, you kind of get used to that. But as students, I know how important this is. So we are doing our best for you guys. We appreciate you tuning in and spreading the word. You guys are wonderful. I love the positivity from everyone. If anything that's come out of all of this, it's really the camaraderie in the ballet world and just being able to connect with so many people, even from Iran. Someone contacted us and just saying how she got to dance now because it's prohibited in her country, but she's able to take this class, and that makes me want to cry because I have pregnancy hormones. So we love you guys and keep in touch, and we will be back soon.
Yeah.
Stay safe, everyone. Ugh.